ナモアミダ仏、ナモアミダ仏、ナモアミダ仏、ナマンダ、ナマンダ、ナマンダ。Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the November 8th Sunday service. For those of you who don't know me, I am Sensei Keith Kato, and it is my pleasure to perform today's service. And as last month, as I said before, and I'll say it again, I'd like to say thank you to Stuart Ito for being today's engineer, and to Reverend Patty Oshta for providing the music for today's gathas. Please join me in opening meditation. A family is a place where a mind lives with other minds. If their minds love each other, the home will be as beautiful as a flower garden. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namanda, namanda, namanda. Now we will chant today's three treasures. So please join me. Three treasures. Fortunate is it to be born into human life. Now we are living it. Rare is it to encounter the teachings of the Buddha. Now we hear it. If we do not seek the truth of the Dharma in this life, in what life shall we find it? Let us reverently take refuge in the three treasures of the truth. I take refuge in Buddha. May we all together absorb into ourselves the principle of the way to enlightenment and awaken with us our highest aspiration. I take refuge in Dharma. May we all together be submerged in the depth of the Dharma and gain wisdom as deep as the ocean. I take refuge in Sangha. May we all together become units in true accord, in a life of harmony, in a spirit of universal brotherhood, free from the bondage of selfishness. Even through ages of myriad of kalpas, hard is it to hear such an excellent, profound, and wonderful teaching. Now we are able to hear and receive it. Let us thoroughly understand the true meaning of Tathagata's teaching. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namanda, namanda. We will now chant Jusei Ge. Gagon chose gan hishimu jodo shigan fuman zok sepu josho ga gao muryo ko fu Se shu fu sai sho bingu se bu jo sho ga がし成仏道妙所長寿法空教未生門聖不浄生学利欲人少年上衛守凡行四愚無浄土一生天人師人力縁大公不生無彩道少女三苦名高彩修薬難開悲智慧言滅し困惑安閉塞障悪道通達禅宗門高僧正満足異様老実法日月修住期天公普賢異種海王像高世空独法上大集中説法師四苦供養一切仏具足修得本願念七情満得意三界用如仏無下智通達未普照願楽会力都市最小村志願夜行家大仙の感動国書天人都市妙家阿曼达布，阿曼达布，阿曼达布，阿曼达布，阿。願依師功徳平等誠一切道運菩提心Namandab, Namandab, 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 Namandab. Namandab. Next, we will have the golden chain. Golden chain. I am a link in Amida's golden chain of love that stretches around the world. I will keep my link bright and strong. I will be kind and gentle to every living thing and protect all who are weaker than myself. I will think pure and beautiful thoughts, say pure and beautiful words, and do pure and beautiful deeds. May every link in Amida's golden chain of love be bright and strong, and may we all attain perfect peace. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namanda, 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 namanda. Before we sing our first gatha, a special place, I just wanted to share with you a talk I had with Reverend Kusunoki, formerly of Lodi Buddhist Church and now Rinban of Seattle Buddhist Church. And he had told me as I was going through my training at the BCA Center, Jodo Shinshu Center in Berkeley, that in order to get more out of a Sunday service, especially with the singing of the gathas, that you should sing with the intent of singing coming from the heart. And to not be afraid, even if you have a crummy voice, a crummy singing voice, it's okay. The main thing is that you are participating in the singing of a gatha. And that's really the most important thing. So I invite you in the comfort of your home to please sing. And the side benefit is that you don't have to hear my voice as I'm singing. So we will have the first gatha, a special place. Good morning again. You know, during my 8+ years as a minister's assistant since July 2012, I have participated in many wonderful and new experiences. And one of the most memorable experiences in my life was my involvement in the Youth Advocacy Committee retreats, otherwise known as YAC retreats. Every year from 2005 through 2017, 1 week in July was set aside for the Yak retreat, culminating in the Obon service, Sunday service. Over 200 high school Dharma students from all over the continental United States attended these 13 retreats. One of the hopes and dreams of the Yak retreat was to cultivate future leaders to guide the various temples of the Buddhist churches of America. And I am happy to report that many of the Yak participants are now serving on temple boards, are on national BCA committees, teaching Dharma school, and are advisors to the junior YBA organizations. And I understand one of the first YAC retreat graduate is or will become president of the White River Buddhist Temple. Wow, how wonderful is that? Under the leadership of Reverend Bob and Reverend Patty Oshta, the Yak retreat was patterned after the Tokudo program in Kyoto, Japan, whereby all the Yak participants went through a regimen of learning how to conduct a service, ring the Kansho bell, attend many classes on Buddhist education, and learn about the intricacies of and proper behavior regarding the Onaijin, the altar area of the Hondo. During my time with the Yak retreat, it was a privilege to have met many wonderful young men and women. And my most favorite part of the Yak retreat was to listen to the Dharma messages created and delivered by these young participants. And in particular, there were two Dharma messages that truly left a deep impression with me. And this was out of over 100 Dharma messages. I was so moved that I had asked the two young men for their permission to allow me to share their messages, and both graciously gave me their permission. The first message is from a young man from the Sacramento Buddhist Temple, whom many of you know, and he is Cody Kurahara, whom I've had the privilege to get to know. The second message is from another fine young man from Orange County Buddhist Church, and his name is Jeffrey Onuma. I have edited their letters or messages for length, clarity, elimination of repetition, and also have paraphrased some of their messages. But please note that the essence and the spirit of their original messages speak loudly. And I hope you will enjoy their inspirational messages. And now it is my honor to be the messenger of their messages. The first Dharma message is from Cody Kurahara. The hardest thing about the Youth Advocacy Committee 12 reunion was saying goodbye to the friends who live great distances away from my home in Sacramento. When I got on the plane, I reluctantly acknowledged what was happening, leaving Seattle to fly home. Deep inside, something was really bothering me. Before I could address it, the airplane was rolling forward, accelerated down the runway, and then soared into the air. Next to my seat were two windows. Looking through the back window, I could see slightly behind where the airplane had been, and through the front window, I could see where the airplane was going. I watched as the Seattle-Tacoma Airport disappeared and continued my gaze upon Seattle until it disappeared. The airplane continued to climb higher and higher into the sky. After piercing through the clouds, a looming snowy mountain came into view in the front window. I watched as the mountain moved from the front window to the space between the two windows, and then reappeared in the rear window. Then I remembered what was bothering me. It was not the excitement of flying home and returning to see my parents, nor was it the realization of traveling at incredible speeds in a metal tube thousands of feet in the air. I realized I was leaving my Dharma buddies in Seattle. Each minute in the airplane meant further separation from them. The greater the distance, the sadder I became. I found out how much I truly missed them. Another mountain came into view in the front window, and then it moved to the back window. As I was moping in my seat, I turned my head and looked through both windows. The front window exposed the things that were to come, and the back window showed what the airplane had passed by. The blind spot between the windows represented what was happening at the moment. The back window represented the past, the blind spot represented the present, and the front window represented the future. In the present, we oftentimes are distracted by the past or the future. As the mountain passed from the front window into the blind spot, I knew the mountain was still there, and at some point it would come back into view into the back window. In thinking about my reunion, I realized how much I hurt inside when I had to say goodbye to the people I grew to appreciate and care for. I felt powerless and depressed. On the airplane, the thought of being far away from my newfound friends hit me. However, I discovered how much I truly appreciated the time I had with them when we were together, but also that when we separated, we had to let go. However, special relationships will always transcend time that will allow us to keep each other in our hearts and minds until we next see each other. The Buddhist teaching of the middle path will forever be ingrained in me and help guide me as I live my life. I accept the fact that everything happens for a reason, regardless if that reason is good or bad, and at times out of my control. After saying goodbye to my Dharma buddies for life, I now know that time stands still for no one as it marches on. This made me more aware of the limited time I had with my high school friends, athletics, and family before I head off to college. As I looked through both windows of that airplane, I realized the past allowed me to experience and be grateful for the many wonderful things, and the future will hold many exciting opportunities for me to experience new things. But the greatest gift I have learned is to appreciate living in the present while it is happening and making the most of today. Thank you very much, Cody. As Cody discovered and will continue to discover in his life, living the Nambutsu journey is and will continue to be full of surprises with events and things oftentimes being out of his control. Cody awakened to the concept of right mindfulness that taught him to enjoy the experience in the moment as it is happening, knowing that the reality of impermanence will appear at any time. But at the same time, knowing the teaching of interdependence will enhance and bring more meaning to that experience. Next, I'd like to read to you the Dharma message from Jeffrey Onuma. And I would say out of the over 100 messages that I listened to, this was the one that touched me the most, that hit home. When I was 7, my grandmother was diagnosed with stage 4 colon cancer, The doctors told her that she had only several months to live at best. But my fragile grandmother shocked the doctors with her will to live. She told them, quote, "I'm going to see my grandsons graduate from high school," unquote. She survived for over 8 years. Unfortunately, she passed away 2 years short of my high school graduation. As her health rapidly declined, she started writing letters to me, one for every milestone I was to achieve after her death. This was her way of keeping the pledge she made to herself to be there with me spiritually when I had accomplished each milestone. A year ago, I came home to find that our home had been broken into. Letters from my grandmother had been stolen from the safe. Her dreams of being there with me had been taken away. A stranger had taken away my grandmother's dying words and robbed me of those priceless messages. Unfortunately, those letters were never recovered. As Buddhists, we are taught that everything is impermanent, constantly changing, and eventually disappears. I felt so empty about those missing letters that represented my grandmother's hopes and dreams for me. I felt that I had somehow failed her as I couldn't acknowledge my grandmother through those letters. However, despite the loss of those letters, I still felt my grandmother's love for me. And with that love, I am more than determined to achieve her hopes and dreams for me. My perception about life has changed since the passing of my grandmother. I am more keenly aware of the concept of interdependence that teaches us that everyone and everything are interconnected, representing the oneness of life. Even though human life disappears, I had wondered if the bonds between human beings, such as the love for my grandmother, would go away after her death. I think the special bonds and love between people will always touch our lives and never go away. My grandmother was my best friend for 15 years, and our connection will never fade away as long as I am alive. Our special feeling will never be disconnected. The strength and compassion that defined my grandmother will always be a part of me. As I touch the lives of others, my grandmother will also touch those same lives. Now, for every milestone I achieve in my life, I will write a letter to my grandmother to acknowledge her wishes for me. Like my experience with the loss of my grandmother, I hope each of you will be able to accept and find peace with life's impermanence and constant changes. Thank you, Jeffrey. You know, with the loss of his grandmother, Jeffrey experienced one of the deepest forms of compassion, deep love, and appreciation for another human being. And from the love and the lessons learned from his grandmother, Jeffrey is becoming more mature in thought as well as physical maturity. With his grandmother always in his thoughts, she will continue to inspire Jeffrey to become a better person, the person his grandmother would be so proud of. Recently, I saw a 2017 Disney animated movie, Coco. The scene that caught my eye was when the grandson was singing to his grandmother. And it instantly reminded me of perhaps what Jeffrey and his grandmother might have communicated to each other before her passing. And now I'd like to have Stuart play the song, Remember Me.
Remember me. Though I have to say goodbye, remember me. Don't let it make you cry, for even if I'm far away, I hold you in my heart. I sing a secret song to you each night we are apart. Remember me. Though I have to travel far, remember me. Each time you hear a sad guitar, know that I'm with you the only way that I can be. Until you're in my arms again, remember me.
Thank you, Stuart. You know, the second to the last line, until you're in my arms again, prompted me to think about what Reverend Yuki Sugihara, formerly from the Florence Buddhist Church and who is now the minister for the Portland Buddhist Church, had told me regarding the existence of a Pure Land and what the Pure Land represented to him. Reverend Yuki said, in no uncertain term, that the Pure Land is a place where he will be able to see his mother again and to apologize for not being a good son. You know, after thinking about that for a long time, I now also believe that when my time ends on earth, I look forward to reuniting with my mom and dad and my grandparents in the Pure Land. But before I go there, I am planning to still be around to enjoy and appreciate whatever time I have left in my life with my family and my friends. Before I end today's message, I would like to again give a great big thank you to Cody and Jeffrey for their beautifully inspired Dharma messages. As I read their messages, I discovered that we, the older generation, are never too old to learn from the younger generation. All we have to do is open our Dharma mind and just listen to them. In closing, please join me in Gassho. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namandab, namandab, namandab. Now we will have our second gatha, Amida's Paradise. Join me in closing meditation. For those of us who have experienced deep loss of a loved one, let us always remember, as the song states, though we have said goodbye and we are far apart, let us hold each other in our hearts. Each night we are apart. Know that we are together, the only way we can be for now. But let us remember, until we are in each other's arms again. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namanda, namanda, namanda.